Shalakaya Chaksur Militanina Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschacya Desatarine. Vanchakaupa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going over the sixth canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, and we're on chapter number 3. We're hearing how Yamaraj replies to the Yamadutas. The Yamadutas were feeling disappointed because they had been defeated by the Vishnu Dutas. So they came back to their master Yamaraj and they asked him, is there anybody else above you? We thought you were the supreme. Lord Yamaraj told them, yeah, I'm not the supreme, there's somebody above me, there's the Supreme Personality of Godhead above me. And the four Vishnu Dutas you met, the four servants of Lord Yamaraj, of the four servants of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, they were his representatives, they were acting on his behalf. So they came to protect that man, Ajamila, because he chanted the holy name of the Lord. So Lord Yamaraj explains to the Yamadutas that actually the religious principles are coming from the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Yamaraj 继续解释道,事实上真正的宗教原则就是由至尊人格守神制定的。
Even great sages may be in the mode of goodness, but they cannot decide the religious principles. And even the demigods cannot decide. So ordinary human beings, they cannot do anything. They cannot say what are the religious principles. So when the Yamadutas were asked by the Vishnu Dutas, they were asked by the Vishnu Dutas to say what are the real principles of religion.
Yamadutta受到Vishnu的挑战, 被询问到什么是真正的宗教原则的时候,
So the Yamadutas said the principles of religion are what it says in the Vedas.
Yamaduta 当时就回答, 真正的宗教原则是来自于伟达经所确立的。
But the Yamadutas, they didn't know that there is transcendental literature.
但是亚玛都塔他们并不知道有一种超然的文献。
The Vedas describe ritualistic ceremonies, and they are not transcendental.
而伟达经中所描述的是这些仪式的这些祭祀，那些并不是超然的。
They're just these ritualistic ceremonies are meant to keep peace in the world.
这种各种各样的祭祀仪式，只是为了维持这个世界的和平。
Because there's many materialistic people in the material world, so the Vedic rituals help to keep everything in order and to keep the world peaceful.
因为这个世界上有太多的物欲熏心的那些物质主义者，所以伟达文献事实上只是为了维持这个社会的秩序和和平。
But real religious principles are above the modes of nature, they're transcendental.
而真正的宗教原则是超越于物质的。
So the Yamaduras, they didn't know about anything. They had never heard about transcendental religious principles.
但是亚玛都塔他们并不知道这些超然的宗教原则，他们从来没有听过这些。
So materialistic people, they just have faith in the Vedic rituals.
物质主义者他们只是对伟达经有信心。
But Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that the Vedas deal with the three modes of nature and they should rise above the modes.
但是 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说， 说那些追随伟达经的人声称除了伟达经之外没有别的。
No. They said the Ved, they said the Ved, the Yamadu, the
Krishna
says in the Bhagavad Gita that the Vedas deal with the three modes of nature.
Yes.
And they
Krishna
should,
在《薄伽梵歌》中说，那些伟达经只是处理的物质自然三形态。
And Krishna says to Arjuna, you should rise above the modes of nature.
Krishna 告诉阿尔朱那说，你应该超越物质自然形态。
Right. So also in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes how people may speak the words of the Vedas.
薄伽梵歌中也描述了那些追随伟达经的人，他们是怎么说的。
And they think the Vedas are the highest knowledge.
他们认为伟达经是最高的知识。
And some people, they like to do the Vedic rituals.
有一些人确实是喜欢做伟达仪式。
But they don't know the real purpose behind the Vedic rituals.
但是他们不知道伟达仪式背后的目的是什么。
The rituals are meant to help one that they will gradually come to the transcendental platform.
仪式背后是为了帮助人逐渐地提升到超然的层面上。Krishna
says in the Bhagavad Gita, by all the Vedas I am to be known.
Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说，所有伟达经，我是伟达经的知悉者，我应该通过伟达经应该知道我。
So some foolish people, they just become attached to the Vedic rituals and they never go higher. They don't go up beyond that.
愚蠢的人只是追随伟达经，但是他并不愿意去超越伟达经，不愿意往上走。But
we can understand from Srimad Bhagavatam that real religious principles are given by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And that principle of religion is given in the Bhagavad Gita, that one should surrender to Krishna. So somebody may follow the Vedic scriptures, they may not know this transcendental principle.
因此，一个人或许他追随伟达经典，但是他也许并不明白这些超然的原则。
It's not known to everyone.
并不是每一个人都知道这个事情。
Even the demigods in the higher planets don't even know.
即便是居住在高等星宿的半神人，他们也并不知道。
But this transcendental religious principles can be understood from the Supreme Lord. Or it can be understood from the representatives of the Supreme Lord. So the representatives of the Supreme Lord are the 12 Mahajans. Brahma, Narada, Shiva.
Brahma, Narada, 主 Shiva.
The four Kumaras.
四 Kumara.
The Lord Kapila, the son of Devahuti.
Devahuti的儿子, 主 Kapila.
Svayambhuva Manu. Prahlad Maharaj, Janak Maharaj, Grandfather Bhishma.
Prahlad Maharaj, Janak Maharaj, 以及祖父 Bhishma.
Then Bali Maharaj, Sukadeva Goswami, and Yamaraj.
Bali Maharaj, Sukadeva Goswami, 以及Yamaraj本人.
So these names, 12 people, they're all mentioned by Yamaraj. He's described, he names the 12 Mahajans. So Lord Yamaraj tells these Yamaduras, he says that this transcendental religious principles is called Bhagavad Dharma. And it means to surrender to the Supreme Lord and develop love for Him.
Yamaraj 在这里说, 这超然的宗教原则被称为Bhagavad-dharma, 即臣服至尊主, 爱心服务主。
And to become transcendental, you have to get rid of the modes of nature.
如果你想变得超然的话, 你必须超越物质自然形态的污染。
So this is very confidential and it's very difficult for ordinary people to understand. But if somebody is very fortunate, very lucky, then he can be immediately liberated. And then he can go home back to Godhead. So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna talks about Bhagavad Dharma as religious principles. Krishna tells Arjuna, because you're my good devotee, I am telling you this confidential knowledge.
主 Krishna 跟阿朱那说，由于你是我非常亲爱的奉献，所以我向你解释这门机密的宗教。And
then Krishna tells Arjuna, just surrender unto me and I will free you from all sinful reactions.
主 Krishna 跟阿朱那说，只是臣服于我，放弃其他一切，我将把你从所有的罪恶反应之中解救出来。
So somebody may say, well, This principle, if it's very rarely understood, it's not very useful.
有人或许会说，如果这个原则很难以懂的话，那它有什么用处呢？
But Yamaraj says, you know, you can understand it if you follow the parampara.
Yamaraj 就在这里解释到，如果你追随师徒传承的话。
So we have the four lines of disciplic succession.
我们有四条师徒传系。
From Lord Brahma, from Lord Shiva, from Mother Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, and from the four Kumaras.
有来自于主 Brahma 的、主 Shiva 的、来自于幸运女神 Lakshmi 的，还有来自于四 Kumar 的。
So we are in the Brahma Sampradaya.
我们是属于 Brahma Sampradaya 这个师徒传系的。
And the one from the Sampradaya from Lakshmi is called the Shri Sampradaya. Shri is the name for Lakshmi.
而来自于幸运女神传系的这个名字被称为 Shri Sampradaya. Shri 其实指的就是幸运女神。
So you have, everyone has to decide, you have to take shelter of one of these four Sampradayas to understand this knowledge.
任何人都应该托庇于这四条中的一条去理解这个超然的知识。
You may chant a mantra, but if you don't take them, if you didn't receive the mantra through the disciplic succession, it won't have any result.
我们也许会去唱诵一些曼陀罗，但是如果这个曼陀罗并不是来自于这四个师徒传系的话，那不会有什么作用。
And you have to be very careful because there are many sampradayas which are not bona fide.
而且我们应该非常小心，因为当今有很多并不是正宗的宗教传系。
And they may be giving mantras and telling you things, but they're not unauthorized disciplic succession.
他们或许会告诉你一些事情，然后给你曼陀罗，但是他们并不是正宗的，并不科学。
So if you get initiation in that kind of sampradaya, then it's useless.
如果你在这样的师徒传，在这样的不正宗的你去接受启迪的话，那是没有毫无用处。
You'll never understand the religious principles.
你也永远不会明白真正的宗教原则是什么。
So devotional service begins with the chanting of the holy name of the Lord.
奉献服务开始于唱诵至尊主的名字。
Right? When somebody starts to chant the Hare Krishna mantra, that's the beginning of their spiritual life.
一个人一旦开始唱诵至尊主的圣名 Hare Krishna mantra 的时候，这是他灵性生活的开始。
And the highest religious, this chanting the holy name is the highest religious principle for all the human society.
而且唱诵主的圣名对于所有的人类社会来说是最高的宗教原则。
So the Srimad Bhagavatam, the Bhagavad Gita, they're all teaching this important knowledge.
圣典博迦瓦坛以及博迦梵歌都教授了这门知识。
The Srimad Bhagavatam begins by rejecting all cheating religious systems.
圣典博迦瓦坛在开始的时候告诉我们要拒绝所有的欺骗性的宗教。
Everything in the Bhagavatam is in relation to Krishna, the Supreme Lord.
圣典博迦瓦坛中的一切都与至尊主有连有相关联。
And the Srimad Bhagavatam teaches us that the highest principle of religion is to develop love for the Supreme Lord.
圣典博迦瓦坛也解释到，最高的宗教是为了发展出我们对至尊主的爱。
So this process begins with the chanting of the holy name.
而这个程序 起源于唱诵至尊主圣名。
And when we chant the holy name, and then we begin to dance in ecstasy, then gradually,
当我们唱,
then gradually we will actually see the form of Krishna.
当我们唱诵主的圣名的时候，我们就会开始在狂喜中跳舞，然后逐渐能看到主的形体。
And then we will go on, we will also see the pastimes of Krishna. And we will begin to understand and know more about Krishna's wonderful qualities. So all of these things are there within the chanting of the holy name.
所有这一切都在唱诵主的圣名之中。Right?
We say Naam includes Rup and Guna and Leela.
圣名包含形体、逍遥时光以及品质。So
that way one can understand properly Krishna.
这样一个人就可以恰当地了解到 Krishna.
We can understand how he comes into this material world.
我们可以了解到他是如何来到这个物质世界。
How he takes his birth and what his activities are.
我们可以知道他是如何出生，他有什么样的活动。
So these things can be known by devotional service.
这些都可以通过奉爱服务理解。
Devotional service is the only process by which Krishna reveals himself.
只有通过奉献服务才能够理解至尊主，理解Krishna.
The result of understanding Krishna is described in the Bhagavad Gita that we will never take birth again in this world.
而这个结果，主 Krishna 在《国家梵歌》中也说了，我们再也不会投身到这个世界。
Instead, he will go back home, back to Godhead.
取而代之的是，我们会回归守身，回归家园。And
when we go back to Godhead, we'll never want to come back to this world.
当我们再回归守身之后，我们再也不会回到这个物质世界。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, "Mama paicha punar janma dukalayam ashashvatam." Napnovanti Mahatmana Samsadim Paramam Gata. The great souls who are yogis in devotion, they never return to this material world because they know it to be a temporary place of misery.
伟大的灵魂处于奉爱之中的瑜伽师到达我之后再也不会重返这个充满痛苦短暂的物质世界。
So Yamaraj says to his servants, the Yamadutas, he says, you are as good, you're just like my sons. He said, I want you to see how powerful, how glorious the chanting of the holy name of the Lord is.
Yamaraj 对Yamaduta说道，我亲爱的这些仆人们，我带你们就像，我把你们看作就像我自己的儿子一样，我想让你们看。
Just see that Ajamila was greatly, he was so sinful, and he chanted just to call the name of his son, and he didn't know he was chanting the Lord's holy name. But because he chanted the holy name of the Lord, he remembered Narayan.
但由于他唱诵主的名字，他记起了Narayana。
And he was saved from death.
而且他就被他从死亡那里被获得了拯救。
He didn't have to go to see Yamaraj.
他再也不用去见Yamaraj。
So we don't have to do any research about the chanting of Hare Krishna. The life of Ajamila was proof about the power of the holy name. And we can understand also the position of anybody who chants the holy name. So Lord Chaitanya gave great importance to the chanting of the holy name. And Lord Chaitanya used to quote the Brihad Naradiya Purana, that in the Kali Yuga there's no other way but the chanting of the holy name. So people, we should understand that we can easily get freed from our sinful reactions just by chanting the holy name. And we can also chant about the qualities and the activities of the Lord. So this is the only way in which we can get freed from our sinful reactions. Even if we can't chant with good pronunciation, it doesn't matter. If we chant, the main thing is to chant without offense. We see Ajamila was sinful, but he was not offensive. So when he was dying, he chanted the holy name and he called for his son. And so when he chanted the name of the Lord, he remembered the Supreme Lord. So he got liberated. So, in the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya, we hear about Haridas Thakur, how Haridas Thakur had gone to visit some very rich people. There were these two men, one was called Haranya and the other one was called Govardhan. And one was the father of Raghunath Das, and one was the uncle of Raghunath Das. So the two men were brothers and they were both very rich. And Raghunath was in their house with them. So Haridas Thakur came there to visit, and in that house there was one man who was a Brahmana, but he was not a devotee. So Haridas Thakur was speaking about the power of the holy name, and he said simply by chanting the holy name, one can be liberated. Even though his chanting is not pure, there may be some kind of offense there, something not correct, but still he can get liberation. So the smarter Brahmins, the Brahmanas, these people were Brahmana by birth who are not devotees, and Mayavadis, they don't believe this. Smarter Brahmana means one who is a Brahmana by birth, but not a devotee.
Smarter Brahmanas 是指那些成为了婆罗门, 而是靠出身成为婆罗门，但是并不是奉献者的这样的一些人。
And Mayavadi means one who thinks the absolute truth is illusion.
Mayavadi 是指那些认为绝对真理是不真实，只是一种虚幻。
So, what Haridas Thakur said was actually true. Just by chanting the holy name, even though it's not pure chanting, you can get liberated.
事实上，哈尔达斯塔库所说的这一席话是真实的。即便一个人能，他不是那么纯粹的唱诵生命，他也能够获得解脱。So
there are many references in the scriptures to support what Haridas Thakur said.
在经典中有很多这样的证据可以证明哈尔达斯塔库所说的话。In
one place in the scriptures, it said. If one always chants the holy name with great devotion in the evening and in the morning, then one can get free from all material misery.
第一个论据是这么说的：如果一个人满怀爱心的、日夜不断的唱诵主的圣名，他能免于所有的物质的痛苦。
And then there's another statement that some people can get liberated if they just simply hear the holy name of the Lord constantly, every day, with great respect.
第二段论述讲，如果一个人每天都满怀敬意的、不断的、不间断的聆听至尊主的圣名，他也能够获得解脱。
And then Srimad Bhagavatam says, we should always chant and hear about Krishna.
圣典波迦瓦坦讲到，一个人应该总是不断的聆听和唱诵Krishna.
And we should meditate upon Krishna's activities.
而且我们应该冥想至尊主的Krishna的这些活动.
And we should try to please Krishna.
我们应该试着努力取悦Krishna.
So then there's another quotation that we can get free from all sinful reactions just by remembering the lotus feet of Krishna.
通过日日夜夜记着主的莲花足，一个人能远离一切罪恶烦恼。But
we should remember the lotus feet of Krishna day and night. In other words, all the time, constantly.
这里提到的是 记忆主的日日夜夜的，就是不间断的冥想着主的莲花足，总是冥想着主的莲花足。Then
there's a nice quotation from Srimad Bhagavatam, which says that the chanting of the holy name is all auspicious.
下面一个来自于圣典波迦瓦坦讲述到。 唱诵圣名是极为吉祥的，
and it destroys all sins.
能够摧毁所有的罪恶。
So one should take to this process as soon as possible.
因此，一个人应该尽快的接受这个程序。
So if we constantly hear and chant the holy name, or the fame, or the activities of Krishna, then we get liberated.
如果一个人很长的聆听、唱诵至尊主的圣名、名声以及他的形体和活动的话，他是一个解脱的灵。Just by
uttering the name of Krishna, you get free from all sinful reactions.
只是唱诵主的圣名，一个人就能从所有的罪恶反应中解脱出来。Just
uttering, we may not say it very well, but just uttering, just saying it, somehow coming out of our lips, we get so much benefit.
只是唱了一下，或许发音不是那么的准确，就能从罪恶活动之中解脱出来。
So we should understand there's no need for any other process but the chanting of the holy name. Ajamila, when Ajamila got liberated, that proved the power of the chanting of the holy name. Ajamila didn't exactly remember Lord Narayan. He remembered his son. And Ajamila, at that time, he was supposed to die. He wasn't very clean. He was very sinful. And so, you know, because it's a time of death, so the condition of the mind is not going to be very good. You'll be very disturbed. So it must have been very difficult for Ajamila to chant properly. But Ajamila got liberation because he chanted the name of the Lord. So if somebody is not sinful like Ajamila, then they have a much better chance. We have to be determined, we have to make a vow to chant the holy name. Then we'll be saved from Maya and we can get the mercy of Krishna. So even people commit offenses, they're recommended to chant the Hare Krishna mantra.
If they
chant, then gradually one day they will chant without offense. So by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, gradually we will awaken love for Krishna. The goal of life is to develop love for Krishna. So we should always remember what is our goal. Krishna told the same to Uddhava. He told Uddhava. Uddhava was a very good friend of Krishna. So Krishna told Uddhava that what is the highest religious system for people.
Krishna 也跟乌达瓦说，乌达瓦是主Krishna非常好的朋友。主Krishna跟乌达瓦说，说到了人类社会上最高的宗教体系是什么？
And he told him the highest religious principle is that which helps us to awaken love for Krishna. So if we have love for Krishna, we don't have to worry about liberation. Even if in the beginning we chant Hare Krishna mantra with offenses, gradually we will become free. If we keep chanting. But you have to chant again and again, you have to chant constantly. So we can get free from the sinful reactions if we chant all day and all night. So Lord Chaitanya tells us, in the Kali Yuga, there's no other way but the chanting of the holy name.
主 Chaitanya 再次说到, 在卡尼年代, 除了唱诵圣名之外,
so Srila Prabhupada tells us that if we remember to strictly follow Lord Chaitanya's instruction, then we will be in a good condition.
圣帕帕德说, 如果我们严格追随主柴潘尼亚的忠告的话, 我们的处境将会是很好。
You just have to hold on to the chanting of the holy name.
我们得抓住唱诵主, 唱诵圣名的这个方法。
So Yamaraj is still giving instruction to his servants, the Yamadutas. So he mentions about other people who wrote scriptures which are not about devotional service. And he wrote about, he mentions the names, people like Jaimini, who wrote the philosophy of Karma Mimamsa. And Jaimini is teaching that karma is supreme. And then another person is Yajnavalkya. So Yajnavalkya, he's teaching that the impersonal Brahman is the supreme, and everything comes from the Brahman. And there are other scriptures by different people, but none of these people can know the real religious principles.
还有其他的一些这些文献的撰写者, 但是所有的这些人都不能明白真正的宗教原则是什么。
They cannot understand the transcendental system of devotional service.
他们不能理解超然的奉献服务的这个宗教原则。
They don't know the value of chanting Hare Krishna mantra.
他不知道唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra的
No, their minds are just attracted to ritualistic ceremonies in the Vedas. So their intelligence becomes very dull. And they may spend a lot of time collecting all the things they need to perform the rituals, but they get no real benefit. They get some temporary benefit, like they can go to heaven and enjoy material happiness there.
他们只是得到了一些非常短暂的利益，比如说去到天堂星球。
So they're more interested in material religion, and then economic development, and sense gratification, and liberation.
他们关心的是宗教仪式、经济发展、感官享乐以及解脱。
But they're not attracted to Sankirtan movement. So anyone who chants the holy name without offense, they can get the highest success. So somebody may ask, then why did Krishna arrange so many Vedic rituals? And why are people so attracted to these rituals? So Yamaraj is answering this question.
Yamaraj 就回答了这个问题。
These people, they're only attracted to material religion. They don't understand the value of transcendental religion.
这Yamaraj说，这些人只被物质的宗教感兴趣，他们不被超然的这个宗教所吸引。
The real purpose of the Vedas is to understand Lord Krishna. But these people get so attracted by the doing the Vedic yagyas, they think that's the real goal. They'll spend a lot of money and they'll hear many mantras, Vedic mantras chanted. And Prabhupada remarks, he says, sometimes even we have to watch these Vedic rituals being performed. No, we have to watch these things just to please these people, so that they won't complain. If we don't watch it, then they'll complain about us. So then Prabhupada explains, he said, when we opened the Krishna Balaram temple in Vrindavan, that time we had to invite some of these Vedic Brahmanas to come and do some rituals. Prabhupada said there's many of the people in Vrindavan, they're not real devotees, they're Brahmanas and by birth, but they're not very real devotees, they're just like Vedic rituals only. And Prabhupada said these people, they wouldn't accept all the Westerners coming to do all these rituals. They say these people are not qualified. So Prabhupada said, for the sake of keeping the people happy in Vrindavan, we had to pay these Brahmanas to come to do the yagyas. But he said, actually, the real sacrifice for the installing the deities was done by Sankirtan.
建确立神像的这个庙宇，我们是通过齐颂圣名的方式进行的。
So the devotees who were doing the Sankirtan, they were the ones who were actually calling the deities to come to enter into the deity, to be in the temple.
当奉献者在做齐颂圣名的时候，事实上他们真正的呼唤了神像，呼唤了主进入到神像来确立了神像。
So Prabhupada said the Sankirtan done by our devotees coming from Western countries was more important than any of these Vedic rituals. So when these Brahmanas were doing the Vedic rituals, at that time also the Sankirtan was going on, so they were both going on at the same time. So the ceremonies, the Vedic rituals, they were being done for people who are only interested, who only believe in those things.
相信着伟达仪式的人为他们而准备。
These people who like Vedic rituals, their goal is to go to higher planets, to go to heaven, and in heaven they'll perform these rituals every day.
想做伟达仪式的人，他们是想要提升到天堂星球，是为他们准备的。他们的目标是为了这个。
But the people who are doing Sankirtan, they're the pure devotees, and their interest is to please Krishna.
但是做 Sankirtan 的齐颂圣名的人奉献者，他们是为了取悦 Krishna， 他们是纯粹的奉献者，为纯粹奉献者而准备的。
That is pure devotional service.
这是纯粹的奉献服务。
And Prabhupada said, we could have simply performed, we could have done the installation ourselves just by doing Sankirtan.
圣帕帕德说，我们可以只是做 Sankirtan.
To install the deities, we could have just done Sankirtan.
为了确定神像，我们可以只是做 Sankirtan.
But if we did that, the people of Vrindavan would not accept our temple as being bona fide.
但如果我们只是做 Sankirtan 的话，在 Vrindavan 的那些居民，他们不会认真地接受我们的庙宇为正宗的庙宇。
They would say that we did not do the proper ceremonies to install the deities.
他们会觉得我们并没有做恰当的仪式来确立神像。
But actually, these Vedic rituals are just meant for these people who have a dirty brain, who don't have good intelligence.
事实上，这些伟大仪式只是为那些并没有很好智慧的人准备的。
These people are just attracted by the language of the Vedas.
他们只是喜欢伟大的华丽辞藻。
And that language of the Vedas is meant to just help people go to the higher planets.
这个伟大的华丽辞藻帮助他们去到更高等的星球。
So in the fifth canto Srimad Bhagavatam, the people from the higher planets, the demigods in the higher planets,They lament that they only came to heaven. They want to go back to Brahmaloka. They want to go back to Bharatvarsha to take birth again on earth.
在《Srimad Bhagavatam》的第五篇，我们学习到那些居住在天堂星球的高等星球的这些人，他们非常的悲伤，投身在这个地方。他们甚至都想返回到 Bharatvarsha 之地。
Because they know that.Going to the higher planets just means after some time they'll have to go back again, they have to go down. They come up to heaven and then they go back to earth, and then from earth they can go back up again to heaven and then come back again. So in the Kali Yuga, Sankirtan is all we need.
而在卡利年代，这个齐颂圣名是我们所需要的。
And Prabhupada said we should just continue to do Sankirtan in front of the deities, especially in front of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's deities.
圣帕帕德说，希望我们的所有的成员在神像面前做 Sankirtan 运动，尤其是在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的面前做 Sankirtan。
We don't need to do anything else.
我们不需要做其他别的。
But to keep ourselves clean in both the habits and in the mind, we have to worship the deity.
但是为了保持我们的心意和习惯，有一个好的习惯以及干净，以及保持我们洁净，我们必须得崇拜神像。
And we have to follow the regulative principles, like hearing and chanting.
如此，我们也要追随这些规范原则，聆听以及唱诵。
So Jiva Goswami, one of the leaders of the Goswamis, he tells us that actually Sankirtan is enough for the perfection of life.
圣吉瓦 Goswami 说，只是 Sankirtan 能够就足以能够使人达到生命的完美。
But still, the worship of the deity has to continue.
但是我们崇拜神像还得继续下去。
And that will help the devotees to keep clean and to keep pure.
这样才能保证奉献者保持洁净和纯净。
Yeah, because when you worship the deity, you have to be very clean. You have to go take bath, you have to put clean cloth, you have to... Many things required to worship the deity properly. Prabhupada's spiritual master, Srila Prabhupada's spiritual master, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, he said that we have to follow both processes at the same time. Both processes means Sankirtan and deity worship. We have to do both at the same time.
因此，圣帕帕德的灵性导师 Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur 就说，我们应该同时遵循这两条程序，一个是 Sankirtan 齐颂圣名，另外一个是神像崇拜。
Just like when we perform arti, when you perform arti, there should be kirtan, there has to be Sankirtan.
就像我们在做 arti 的时候，我们也应该做 Sankirtan.
So Prabhupada said this is very important, and we have to continue this standard, this principle.
圣帕帕德说，我们这个是一个非常重要的，我们应该保持我们的标准原则。
Okay, we will stop here.
Okay.
I will ask if there's any questions.
Yes. One question from Vrindavan Ishvari.怀念 Krishna 小时候 Gopa 的形象和逍遥时光可以吗？还是必须想着 Krishna 十五岁以后的形象？Can I just remember the Krishna's Gopa form and the pastime of the Gopa? Or I should remember or meditation?The Krishna's pastime after 15 years old.
Well, Lord Chaitanya teaches us that the supreme form of Krishna is when he's a young man. Yes, so when he's a young man, that's the form which we are usually worshipping.
主 Chaitanya 的教导是我们应该经常冥想 Krishna, 他作为一个青年的时候的这个样子。
If you worship Krishna in Gopal form, that's not the mood of Lord Chaitanya.
如果你想崇拜主 Krishna Gopal 的这个形象的话，这并不是主 Chaitanya 的心态。
Gopal is a little young boy, so if you're going to worship Gopal, you have to cook special food for the young boy.
Gopal 是一个小男孩，婴儿。小男孩，如果你想崇拜这个 Gopa 的这个形象的话，你得做一些小男孩婴儿的他才能吃的食物。
Just like, you know, when you bring up a child, when you have a young child, you have to give the child things which are easy to eat.
就像你抚养一个孩子的时候，我们知道在抚养孩子的时候，当小孩还是很小的时候，他得吃一些。很容易消化的食物。
And there are many other things which you have to do for the young child.
而且还有其他很多的事情得为这个小孩子做。
So, of course, you know, you can do it, but it's not very easy. It's not the program in Lord Chaitanya's movement. Lord Chaitanya.He teaches everyone to follow the mood of the gopis.
你可以这么去做你想要的， 但是呢，这个确实不是我们主柴坦尼亚的运动。主柴坦尼亚的运动是我们怀着勾引木流姑娘的心态。
He said they are the greatest devotees of Krishna.
因为他们是主 Krishna 最好的奉献者。
So we want to learn how to love Krishna from their example.
因此，我们想以他们的榜样来学爱着 Krishna.
And we like to worship Krishna along with his potency. That means Radharani.
而且我们希望崇拜 Krishna 的时候是和他的能量在一起，这就意味着。他必须和 Radharani 在一起。
Krishna is not so beautiful on his own. Krishna is more beautiful when he is with his potency.
Krishna 一个人的时候，没有他和他的奉献者在一起的时候更漂亮。
不是奉献者，他的 potency。
Krishna 和他的能量在内在能量在一起的时候，他会更美丽。
So we see Krishna is worshipped along with Radharani, and Lord Ramachandra is worshipped with Mother Sita, and Lakshmi is with Lord Narayan.
我们看到我们在崇拜主 Krishna 的时候是有 Krishna 和 Radharani, 然后 Sita 和 Rama, 然后 Lakshmi Narayana.
You're going to worship Krishna as a baby, young boy, Balagopal.He's on his own, only you and him.
你如果崇拜主 Krishna 这个 Gopa 的话，那只有你和 Krishna 两个人。
You want to be Krishna's mother.
你想成为 Krishna 的母亲。
Or you want to follow the example of Mother Yashoda.
或者说你想追随 Yashoda 母亲的榜样。
So you have to learn how to serve Krishna as a young child.
那你就得学习如何取悦一个小 Krishna.
You can meditate on Krishna's childhood pastimes.
你当然可以冥想主 Krishna 的童年的逍遥时光。
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay.Next question from Yashoda Devi. 圣帕帕的要旨写了，有了灵感，有了活动者，活动就会以信念为中心的所有的感官的帮助下得以真正的实施。如何正确理解以及执行这句话？博伽梵歌4.8.41-45。First.Srila Prabhupada in his purport said, when we have some feeling and the worker and the activities, then will be applied with faith. 活动者就会在以信念为中心。
在什么地方？波伽梵歌什么地方？
他前面是个说的，没有说在什么地方。后面，我再把这个后面说一下。《博伽梵歌》8.41-45说，按自己的本性所，
第一个问题是就是《博伽梵歌》的十八章第18节，那个是后面第二个问题了。
18章18节。
对。
All right, knowledge, the object of, and Dayauja has his eye, knowledge.
Purport.
Okay.
有了活动者十
个部分。Okay. 他的问题。
I think,
there are
how to understand I think the second last sentence
of the purport.
Yeah. 有了激励，有了活动者。
When the inspiration is there and the worker is there,
yes.
Actual activity takes place by the help of the senses, including the mind, which is the center of all the senses. So when the inspiration is there and the worker is there, then actual activity takes place by the help of the senses, including the mind, which is the center of all the senses. The sum total of all this, of all the constituents of an activity, is called the accumulation of work. All right, so what is being described here?
He just want to know how to understand this.
Okay.
To understand how to act with these two sentences.
All right, so Prabhupada is talking about inspiration. In order to work, there has to be some inspiration to do an activity.
圣帕呢在这里讲到了要有一些激励和一些灵感。
Right, so then he said we may get inspiration from the scriptures or from the instruction of the guru. So for any activity, the worker, you need a worker, and you have to, the worker has to have also that inspiration to perform the work.
而那个工作者必须要有这种激励去从事这种工作。
And then he will do the activity, he'll do the work, he'll perform the activity.
下一步他就会去从事这个工作。
And of course, to do any activity, he has to use his senses, he has his working senses to perform the activity.
当他在从事这个工作的时候，肯定是会用到他的感官的。
And the mind is the center of all the senses.
心意就在所有的感官的中心。
The mind is going to give direction to the senses how to work.
心意会告诉感官指导如何去工作。
So, this is a description of every activity, what happens when we work.
这个其实就是经典在描述我们是怎么样工作的。
Every Prabhupada writes, work takes the form of action. Means you perform action, you're doing activities.
Action.
活动。
圣帕帕的说我，活动。
Work. Work.
圣帕帕的说我们呢。
Our work, we could say, work, zijer, duty, like that, work, 工作,
我们的工作, 我们的职责。
If you have a job, if you're going to do some work, you're going to go to work, it means you're going to do some activities, you'll be doing action, you'll have to perform some different actions.
如果我们有一些职责的话，我们会为这个事情而做一些活动。
Just like somebody's a cook, right? Your job is to cook. Your job is to cook. So you're going to go into the kitchen, you're going to get the vegetables, you're going to wash them, you're going to cut them up, and then you're going to cook them.
就像如果你是一个厨子，你就得去买菜、洗菜、切菜，然后烹饪这个菜。
Or you may be the pujari. Then the pujari, he has to make up the arti tray, he has to get the ghee wicks, he has to get the incense, he has to make up the plate for the offering, and then he has to first of all do the offering, and he has to take the offering in and offer to the deities, then bring the offering out, then perform the arti.
如果你是一个祭师，那你就得准备所有的香灯水等等这些东西，然后给神像供奉，供完之后把这个给取下来，然后做 arti。
So you may ask the devotee, what work do you do? You may say, I'm a pujari.
人们会问你在做什么，然后你就会回答，我是一个祭师，我是一个 pujari。
So pujari has the different actions which he has to do to be the pujari.
如果他是一个普加人，就是说做一个普加人的话，他就有关于这个普加人分内的各种职责、各种活动。
But before he's going to do anything, there has to be that inspiration. It has to be that he wants to do it. You know, the inspiration is like the desire that he wants to do it.
但是在做这个之前，他必须有一些经历，有一些灵感。他有一些鼓励，他有这种渴望，他想去做这个事情。
If the workers have no inspiration, they will be lousy workers. They won't do any good work.
如果他没有受到任何的这个激励的话，他不会做好他的工作。
Okay.
Okay. Next is from the Bhagavad Gita chapter 8, verse.41-45, 按照自己的本性活动，人就会变得完美。18.61要旨，人如果拒绝按至尊主指示行事，就会被迫按他的本性行事。如何正确理解这两段话呢？ In the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 8, verse.41-45,
he said. No, just a minute. Chapter 8, verse 41-45. No way.
Yeah.
There's no 48-45 in chapter 8. It must be chapter 18. Chapter 8 is a small chapter. Chapter 8,
okay.
It only, the last verse is 28.
Okay. Thank you, Manajin.这个是不是粘贴错了？
You say chapter 8, 1848, maybe.
41 to
41. What is it? 41 to?
可能是18章的四。故事说这个第八章，我刚查到，故事说第八章没有41-45，这应该是第十八章。OK.And I see the question. If we work with our nature, then the people will become the perfect. But in the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 18 and verse 61 in the purport said, if we reject the Supreme Lord in formula, then we will be forced.By our nature and work, how to understand?
Yes, Krishna says in the 18th chapter, by performing your duty, you can achieve perfection. And then she's saying in verse number 61, what is she saying?
If we reject the Supreme Lord,And number two, just 只是形式
Are you sure?
Then we will be forced.
Okay, so that's not number 61, that's number 60.
Okay.
I think that she's talking about number 60. It says, because number 60 says, under illusion, you are now declining to act according to my direction. But compelled by the work born of your own nature, you will act all the same. Right?
Yes, I also.
So she's arguing that this is contradictory.
Yes. Thank you, Rudy.
Well, you have to understand everything properly. There's no contradiction.
你得恰当的理解这一切，没有矛盾的地方。
Lord Krishna is pointing out in number 60, verse number 60, that Arjuna was thinking not to fight.
在18.60里面讲到，就是说 Arjuna 他不想作战。
But Arjuna's nature is a Kshatriya, and he's going to act, he's going to fight.
但是 Arjuna 的本性就是一个刹帝利，他一定会去作战的。
Because it's just born, it's his nature, and that nature is going to come out in him. So Krishna said earlier, by performing your duty, you will achieve perfection. Whatever your duty in the different varnas, then if you do them properly, you can achieve perfection.
Krishna 在之前说到的是，如果你按照你的职责去活动的话，你会获得完美的。你在社会四阶层这个里面，你无论根据你的职责去做什么，你都会，如果按照此去执行的话，你能够得到完美。
And so Krishna is saying this is saying that you're not going to be able to give up your nature.
Krishna 在这里说的是，你无法放弃你的本性。
Arjuna was thinking not to fight, but Krishna said, you know, your nature is to fight, you're a Kshatriya.
Arjuna 想放弃他的这个工作，他的职责，但是 Krishna 说你是一个Kshatriya，你不能，你无法放弃你的本性。
Just like somebody is a businessman, they're a Vaishya, they have the business propensity to make money, to buy and sell and make money.
就像一个人，如果他是生意人的话，他总会有这种冲动和这种行为，想去买和卖赚钱。
So, wherever you take that person, wherever he goes, he thinks about how to make money. He says, "I can buy this and sell it there and make money." He's a Vaishya.
如果一个人他总是想着哪里有买，哪里有卖，哪里能够赚钱，这样的一个人，他是一个歪手。
So he can do his business for Krishna, that and that way it becomes perfect.
因此，他就可以做他的生意，然后为了 Krishna 去做他的生意，同时呢，他就可以达到完美。
So Krishna said the same thing in verse number 45 in the Bhagavad Gita.
Krishna 在这个十八章四十五节也讲到了同样的事情。
Everybody becomes perfect. They do their duty. They do what they're supposed to do.
每一个人做他的原则，做他的职责，做他应该做的事情。
Because they're by birth, they're endowed with different qualities. We should recognize our nature, our qualities, and act in that way.
通过经过出生，我们得到我们自己的本性，我们应该认识到我们的自己的这个本性，然后以此为活动。
So education is meant for that. It's meant to understand a person's nature and to then to train him according to his nature.
教育其实就是这样，让我们能够认识到自己的本性，然后根据这个本性去活动。
Somebody's trained to be a brahmana, and somebody's trained to be a manager, and somebody's trained to be a farmer.
有人被教育，就是说有人教育者，被教育者要去做一个 brahmana, 一个婆罗门，有人被教育者去做一个农夫，等等这一些。
So when they're given a particular job according to their nature, then people are happy doing that.
当我们根据自己的本性得到，就是说我们得到的一个工作是根据自己的本性的话，我们会感觉到得到这个工作会很快乐。
But if they have to do something different from the nature, they're not happy.
如果我们得到的这个工作并不符合自己的本性，我们就不快乐。
So Krishna's making that point.
所以 Krishna 就讲出了这个要点。
If Arjuna tries to do something which is not his nature, he won't be happy.
如果 Arjuna 做的事情不是符合他的本性，他也不会快。
And he will come back to his original job, his original nature.
而且他还会回到他原初的这个工作上，他必须回，他一定会回到他原初的工作上做他的事情。
Okay.
Okay.Next question also from Yasho Devi. This verse is from Srimad Bhagavatam, verse chapter 7, oh, canto 7, chapter 12, and verse 30. 这个诗节说到土溶于水中，水融入太阳的光，这些光融入空气之中，空气融入天空，天空融入假我，假我融入总体的物质能量，总体的物质能量融入不展示的成分之中。
Chapter 12, Canto 7, Chapter 12, Verse Number 30.
Yeah, 七十二三十。
I hope she got it right this time.Oh, I don't think so. What's the verse about?
30.
Is it the mind, along with all material desires, should be merged in the moon demigod?
Sati Mataji, 他好像念出了这个，又好像有点哦。
Is it like that?
Yes.
Really? What's your question, Tadawenti Shishama?
How do you understand these words? 土融入水中，土融入水中，水融于太阳，太阳的光，这些光融入空气之中。
Well,that's another class, you know. She'll have to wait for that one. That's a,
okay.
It's a whole big, there's no purport. So,
这些诗没有要旨，所以我们
I'm not going to
这是另外一节课。
Yeah. That's a whole big section, you know. And I can't tell you I understand every verse in the Bhagavatam. So,
我不能告诉你我能理解博伽瓦坛的所有的诗节。
Go ahead. Is that it?
Okay. Yes. Next question from Harini. 顶拜 Gurudev, 顶拜所有聚会的奉献者。Krishna Priya, 请问这个是 Krishna Priya, 请问 Gurudev, 怎样才能做到没有冒犯的唱诵圣名? How to chant with no offense?
Do more chanting. Practice.
更多的唱诵，然后练习。
Yes. 下一个问题。
下一个问题 ，also from Yashoda Devi. This from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 8, 5 chapter and verse number 5. 译文说。Krishna 在星云女神的请求下创造了另外一个外昆塔星球。那我就想问，为什么星云女神要请求再创造另外一个外昆塔星球呢？它原本的外昆塔星球的区别是什么呢 ？In that verse, it said the Lakshmi Devi asked Krishna to create another Vaikuntha. I want to ask why Lakshmi Devi.Want to create another Vaikuntha plant, any other different from the original Vaikuntha, between the original Vaikuntha and this another Vaikuntha plant?
Well, Krishna created another Vaikuntha planet because it was her desire. Lakshmi wanted it.
也 Krishna 创造这个是因为幸运女神的愿望。幸运 She asked why the Lakshmi want this, want another Vaikuntha.
Well, they wanted to have their own Vaikuntha.
Yeah, why the Lakshmi Devi want to create another Vaikuntha?
I don't know, we'll have to ask her. Well, one thing, it's within the universe. This Vaikuntha is within the universe. So she wanted to have a Vaikuntha within the universe. She didn't want to have to go all the way to Vaikuntha to be there, to enjoy the spiritual world there. She wanted to have a Vaikuntha there in the material world. And it says, yeah, just like the demigods, you know, they have their residences. They have residences in different places. It's not like they just have to live in one place. And so Lakshmi wanted to have another place. She doesn't want to have to go all the way to Vaikuntha all the time. She wants to have her own Vaikuntha in the material world also. When she comes to the material world, she wants to have a place where she can be.
就像半世人他们有各种不同的地方待一样， Lakshmi Devi 他也想，当他来到这个当他来到这个物质世界的时候，他也能够在这个宇宙之内有一个Vaikuntha，他也不想到处跑来跑去。
Just like in China, so many people, they have one house in the city, they have another house in the countryside, they have one house in Beijing, they have another house in Shanghai.
就像在中国有很多人，有人在北京有一个房子，有人在乡村还有个房子，有人在上海还有个房子。
So why shouldn't the goddess of fortune have another place?
她为什么不能有她自己的地方呢？
Why you have a problem about this?
你为什么有这样的一个问题呢？ She wants to ask, what's the difference between the Vaikuntha planet and this another Vaikuntha?
No difference.
没有区别。
So the planet, one is in the material realm and one is in the spiritual realm.
一个是在物质的区域范围，一个是在灵性。Okay, next question from Vaishnavi Vani. She said with English, Hare Krishna, Ajamila just chant the name of his son and did get his mantra Narayana previously from some devotee in the descending succession.My doubt is how the name worked so effective without getting it from the spiritual master. Hare Krishna, 阿迦弥勒唱诵这个名字，他是否得到这个 Narayana 的名字，是在前身从一个师徒传神的奉献者那里得到的呢？我的疑问是，他是如何，这个圣名是为什么如此有效？他并没有从一个灵性导师那里得到这个名字。
No,
既然这个名字还如此有效。
You have to understand that Ajamila was born a Brahmana. So when he was a young man, he was trained in the Brahminical culture. So at that time he learned about Narayana and he was given the holy name from qualified people.
我们得知道这个阿迦弥勒他是在一个婆罗门的家庭出生，在他年轻的时候他得到训练，然后在那个时候他一定是从一个有资格的那个人得到了这个名字 Narayana。
Otherwise how would he know to give the name Narayana? He learned the holy name when he was a young brahmana. He's a brahmana by birth. And as a young brahmana, he was a very good brahmana. He used to he was worshipping Shaligram Shila. So he knew about Narayana. And then, after he met the Vishnu Duras, he heard the Vishnu Duras glorifying Lord Narayana, so he got more benefit from them.
在之后，他遇到了维什努都塔，而且呢，他听了维什努都塔在荣耀纳拉扬呢，所以他又从维什努都塔那里得到进一步的利益。
And then he went to Hardwar, and he was staying in a Vishnu temple there.
再之后，他去到了哈德瓦，在那里他住在一个维什努的庙宇之中。
And he gave up his body on the bank of the Ganga and went back to Godhead. So no problem. He got good instruction. He got good direction from bona fide, qualified people.
所以没有问题，他。 Sorry, Gurudev.
He got good instruction when he was a young man.
他是从正确的那个正宗的那里得到了很好的训示。
And then he got good instruction from the Vishnu Duras.
而且他之后他又从维什努都塔那里得到了好的训示。
And then he went to the temple, Vishnu temple in Hardwar. He must have got more instruction there.
然后他又去到了哈德瓦的那个维什努庙宇之中，也得到了很好的训示。Okay,
下一个问题。
Okay, 下一个问题 from Yashodevi, Bhagavatam, Canto 8, 5 Chapter, Verse 24. 圣帕帕的要旨说，奉献者全都是半神。How do you understand this sentence?
Means,
Srila Papa said,
okay.
Devotees are all demigods.
Yes,
you understand.
Because
yes.
Devotees have qualities. They have the quality, good qualities. If they're devotees, they will have the good qualities. There's two kinds of people. There's Daivi Sampad and Asurik Sampad. There's the devotee, there's the people who are like demons and the people who are like demigods. So the devotees are like demigods.
因为奉献者都有很好的品质，有两种人，一个是有很好品质的半神，一个是没有这些很好品质的恶魔们。奉献者都有很好的品质。Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Next question from Pushpasara Mataji, 顶拜 Gurudev, 顶拜 翻译， 请问 Bhishma 是至尊主的奉献者， 但他却被 但他却支持Duryodhana，他是Krishna的十二位代表之一，那他代表了什么呢？感恩Hare Krishna. Obeisance to Gurudev. Because Bhishma Devi is the Lord devotee, but he supports the Duryodhana. He is the one of the Mahajan. What he represents?
What he represents?
Well, yeah, because yes.
You can read the instructions given by Grandfather Bhishma laying on the bed of arrows. Grandfather Bhishma, you can read also, Maharaj Yudhisthira came there, and Maharaj Yudhisthira was very worried because he was responsible for the death of so many people, and he didn't think he should be the king. But Bhishma directed him.
你可以阅读《圣典波迦瓦坛》第一篇，就讲到了优智提尔，他对成为他，因为他为这个世界死了这么多人，他感觉到非常的自责。于是这个时候，他去找毕什马德夫，毕什马德夫躺在舰床上，给了他一些训示。你可以读这一段。
So Bhishma Dev spoke for many, many days on many different subjects to instruct Maharaj Yudhisthira how to rule the kingdom.
Bhishma Dev 花了很多的时间讲述了很多的主题去教导 Yudhisthira Maharaj 如何去管理这个世界。
The main part of the Mahabharata is Bhishma instructing Maharaj Yudhisthira.
而且 Mahabharata 这部史诗的一个很重要的部分，主要的部分也是 Bhishma Dev 教导 Yudhisthira.
Most Mahabharatas they don't include the instructions of Bhishma because it's so big, it's so long, it takes so much.So most people, they just leave it out and they write only about the battle.
大多数的这个 Mahabharata 的这个版本它并没有把 Bhishma Deva 给 Yudhisthira Maharaj 的教导列入到其中，因为这一部分对话或者说这个教导实在是太长太多了，他们只是关心这个战场，所以就把这个给移出去了。
So then Bhishma shows us a perfect example of how to leave the body, because as it came time for him to leave the body, Lord Krishna came right in front of him, and Bhishma Dev began to speak about all the glories of Lord Krishna.
而且 Bhishma Dev 向我们展现了如何去离开，展现了如何离开躯体的这个榜样，因为在他离开躯体的时候，主 Krishna 来了，而且他面对的主 Krishna。
So it said when Hari
讲述了很多关于 Krishna 的荣耀。
Yeah, and he left the body with his eyes focused on Lord Krishna, who was right in front of him.
当他离开躯体的时候，他的眼睛一直专注着看着 Krishna.
So it said, Haridas Thakur and Grandfather Bhishma, they are the two great, perfect examples of how to leave the body.
Haridas Thakur 和祖父 Bhishma 他们都是很完美的榜样，告诉我们如何离开躯体。
Giving up the body directly in the presence of the Supreme Lord.
都在至尊主的面前，直接在至尊主的面前离开躯体。
So Bhishma Dev teaches us all the knowledge about how to live in the world and how to rule the world, and then he shows us how to leave the world.
所以 Bhishma Dev 告诉我们如何生活在这个世界，如何管理这个物质世界，以及如何离开这个物质世界。
Bhishma had a benediction from his father that he could remain alive as long as he wanted.
Bhishma Dev 从他的父亲那里得到一个祝福，就是他可以根据他想要的时间生存活着。
So when it came to a very auspicious time, Bhishma Dev chose to leave the world.
因此，当这个吉祥的时刻到来的时候，他可以选择他离开这个物质世界。
So he had Lord Krishna come in front of him.
这个时候就是主 Krishna 来到他面前。
Okay. Yes.
Okay. Yes. Next question from Yashodevi. Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 8, Chapter 9 and Verse 9.舍拉帕帕的要旨说，每一位妇女都应当受到保护，或者被丈夫，或者被父亲，或者被儿子保护。没有这种保护，一个妇女将会受到剥削。我们如何正确理解这一句话？同时现代社会的妇女们也没有能够受到很好的保护。那么作为一位就是生活在卡利年的一个女人，应该如何去寻求一个更好的保护呢？她应该做什么呢？ Srila Prabhupada in the purport said every woman should be properly protected by the husband, father or the son. If not properly protected, the woman will be used. Not properly used.So, how
would
you understand this?
Well, we can understand this is a symptom of Kali Yuga, that women are not protected.
我们可以理解到在这个卡利年代女人没有受到很好的保护。
And because women are not protected, that's why we have unwanted children. Varna
Sankara. 因为没有受到很好的保护，所以就有要就是不想要的人口的诞生。
So this is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita.
这个也在《博伽梵歌》中所提到。
Yeah.
Yeah. And then she asked, when, as a woman, how to get the proper protection? What we should we do?
Well, you have to find a devotee husband.
你得找一个奉献者的丈夫。
Somebody who is Krishna conscious, who can give you protection.
如果那一个有 Krishna 知觉的这个人，他给予你保护。
And it's very difficult in Kali Yuga.
这个在卡利年代是很难的。
People are not very well trained. Women, the men are not properly qualified, and the women are not very chaste.
人们并没有得到很好的训练，女人也没有得到很好的保护。
Okay, 下一个问题。
Okay, 下一个问题 from Shama Rajini Devidasi. Hare Krishna, 顶拜古内，感谢翻译，在服务。在服务总是感觉受到了剥削，我们应该如何面对？When we do some service, I feel exploited by others. How should we face this condition?
When I do some service, I feel it's what?
Exploited.
Huh?
Exploited.
Exploited.
Yes, exploited.
When you do service, you feel exploited?
Yeah, how to face this condition?
You feel, when you're doing service for Krishna, you feel people are exploiting you?
当你为 Krishna 做服务的时候，你感觉到有人在剥削你，是吗？
Well, if you're doing service for Krishna, you shouldn't. Krishna is not going to exploit you.
如果你为 Krishna 做服务的话 ，Krishna 是不会剥削你的。
If you're doing it for Krishna, then Krishna will give you eternal benefit.
如果你为 Krishna 做服务，你得到的是永恒的益处。
It's going in your spiritual bank account.
它会进入到你的灵性的账户里面。
You have to I don't know, I mean you feel people are exploiting you. Yeah, in the material world there's exploitation. We know there's a lot of exploitation in the material world.
在这个物质世界确实存在很多的剥削。
But the spiritual worldIn the association of devotees, it's not exploitation.
如果你在和奉献者的联谊中，那个不叫剥削。
Sometimes devotees, they come to Krishna consciousness and they feel they're being exploited because they have that conditioning from before, from the material world. Because in the material world, they were exploited.
有一些人来到这个 Krishna 知觉，他感觉到自己被剥削了。那是因为他们来之前还存在这样的概念，因为他以前存在这个物质世界的时候，曾被剥削过，他有这样的体会还在。
So you have to try to get free from that.Conception from that thinking that you're being exploited.
你应该解从这种被剥削的概念之中解放出来。
You have to develop more loving love and trust for the devotees.
你应该发展出对奉献者的爱以及和信任。
So try to work with people who you can trust and who you have more feeling for.
你和那些你更相信的，和他们更有信任的这样的奉献者在一起。
Okay.
That's a question from SE 顶拜孤儒翻译和所有的奉献者。薄伽梵歌中中间六章是奉献服务，为什么放在中间？对两边的活动瑜伽和 Gyana Yoga 起到什么样的作用？怎样理解薄伽梵歌中机密、更机密、最机密？感恩孤儒。First question is in the Bhagavad Gita, in the middle, the sixth chapter, there are six chapter are devotional service. Why the Lord put this devotional service in the middle of the Bhagavad Gita?
Because he put the good thing in the middle, just like you get just like a sandwich. Just like a sandwich, you have bread on the outside and you have the good thing in the middle.
Okay. 因为我们会把好的东西放在中间，就像一个三明治，两边夹的，中间就是那个好的。
That's why. Devotional service is in the middle. It's protected. It's covered by karma and jnana.
而且放在中间的话也会得到保护，被这个 jnana 和 karma 所保护着。What are the effects for the karma yoga and jnana yoga?
The effect? What's the effect? Karma
yes.
yoga? Why do you do karma?
When the devotional service in the middle, what's the useful for the karma yoga and jnana yoga?
Karma yoga by action, you can come to, by doing action for the service of Krishna, you can gradually come to bhakti yoga.
通过活动瑜伽，如果加上奉爱的话，一个人可以到达 bhakti yoga.
And then by jnana, by knowledge, cultivating knowledge, you can also come to bhakti yoga.
通过培养知识，你也可以到达奉爱。
还有呢？
Yeah, 还有。How to understand the confidential, more confidential, and most confidential?
Well, why don't you read the 18th chapter more carefully, then you'll understand.
你为什么不读一读这个第十八章呢？这样你就会理解了。
There is knowledge of, first of all, there's knowledge of Brahman, then there's knowledge of Paramatma, then there's knowledge of Bhagavan.
一个是 Brahman 的知识，一个是 Paramatma 的知识，超灵的知识，一个是 Bhagavan 的知识，至尊凡的知识。
Or in the second chapter, Krishna describes the difference between the body and the soul. That's confidential knowledge.
这个主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌的第二章也讲到了这个机密的知识，身体和灵魂的。
Then in chapter 7, Krishna describes about his energies. In chapter 8, he tells you what you need to do to go back to Godhead.
然后在第七章又讲到了。又讲到了这个超然的知识，然后在后面你应该回归守身。
But in chapter 9, Krishna describes the most confidential knowledge, how he takes care of his devotee.
但是在第九章 ，Krishna 讲到了更机密的知识，讲到了他的奉献者。
Okay.
Okay.
The same thing is described again in the 18th chapter. In the 18th chapter.Krishna describes confidential knowledge to understand Brahman.
在第十八章的时候又讲到了，就有这个答案，就是讲到机密的知识 ，Brahman 的知识。
And then he goes on to say that to understand him is the super soul in the heart of everyone. That's more confidential.
机密的知识是这个 Brahman 的知识，就是凡的知识。更机密的知识就是。Paramatma 的知识，超灵的知识。
But when you understand Krishna as the supreme personality of Godhead Bhagavan, outside of everything, then that's the most confidential knowledge.
当我们理解到至尊凡至尊人和守身处 Krishna 就是外在的那个 Krishna 的时候，那个是最积极的知识。
Okay.
Duryodhana's work is karma activities or weak karma.
Duryodhana?
Yeah, Duryodhana 的活动是功利性的活动还是 karma activities or weak karma?
Well, you could say it's weak karma because he's fighting, he's against Krishna, he's opposed to Krishna.
你可以说他是，你可以说他是 weak.因为他是在反对主 Krishna，
he tried to arrest Krishna，
他也想把 Krishna 给绑起来。
That's Vikarma.
And Bhishma's work, which he do.
Well,
activities.
When he was fighting, when they're fighting on the battle of Kurukshetra, that's karma.
当他在Kurukshetra 之野打仗的时候，它是属于 karma。
But when Bhishma is fighting against Arjuna and Krishna, that's bhakti.
但是他和 Arjuna 和 Krishna 打仗的时候，那个是 bhakti 奉爱，就是 Bhishma 的活动在和 Krishna 打仗的时候，那个是奉爱。
Because Bhishma is firing arrows into the body of Krishna.
Krishna 向啊不 ，Bhishma 向这个 Krishna 的身体射箭。
And he's thinking of the arrows like he's offering flowers to Krishna.
他认为他射出了这个箭是向主 Krishna 献上的鲜花。
So the wounds on Krishna's body are like the bites of a lover.
Sorry, Ruben.
The wounds, the injuries by the arrows of Bhishma, which bring out blood from Krishna's body, they're like the, when a lover, when the man may bite the body of the woman out of love for her.
当这个 Bhishma 向 Krishna 射箭的时候，就像一对Bhishma 向这个 Krishna 射箭的时候，就像一对爱恋的这个夫妻，他们之间的这种小打斗一样。
The man bites a woman, he may bite the neck of the woman.
一个男，就是说这个爱侣中的男性可能会打一下女性。
To show his love for her.
但是他说为了展示对她的爱。
So the same way Bhishma is firing arrows to Krishna, is showing his love for Krishna.
So Bhishma Dev 向 Krishna 射出了这个箭，也是展示出，也是展示他对 Krishna 的爱。
Okay.
Okay. As the last question from Yasho Devi, Srimad Bhagavatam Canto 8, Chapter 10, and Verse 40, 舍勒帕帕的要旨说。战场上死去的英雄们立即变成了鬼魂，那个是指半神人还是指恶魔们死了之后变成鬼魂呢？还有在此战之中，半神们死后的鬼魂能够回归吗？恶魔的鬼魂们，他们都去向是哪里呢 ？In this purport, the heroes.Who died in the battle, they become ghosts. And the ghosts, they are the demigod or the demons. Is the demigod become the ghost or the demons become the ghost?
Well, in the battle, if they die in the battle, they don't usually become ghosts.
通常情况下如果战场上死去，他不会成为鬼魂。
I don't know. I have to look at it. Where is it? Chapter 8?
Chapter, Canto 8, Chapter 10, Verse 40.
Chapter 10,
Verse 40.
verse 14.
Yeah, the purport.
Many helmets, trunks were generated on that battlefield with weapons in their arms, those ghostly trunks which could see with the eyes in the fallen heads, attacked the enemy. With weapons in their arms, those ghostly trunks which could see with the eyes in the fallen heads, attacked the enemy soldiers. It appears that the heroes who died on the battlefield immediately became ghosts, and although their heads had been severed from their bodies, new trunks were generated, and these new trunks, seeing with the eyes and the severed heads, began to attack the enemy. In other words, many ghosts were generated to join the fight, and thus new trunks appeared on the battlefield. 他的问题是什么?
嗯, is this ghost from the demigod or the demon?
Could be either side.
都有可能, 就是说既有可能是半神, 有可能是恶魔。 If the demigod become the ghost, whether can they go back to the Godhead?
Yeah, we can still go back to Godhead. The planets of, you know, there's a planet for ghosts, you know. It's a higher planet, but usually people killed on the battlefield, they don't go back to Godhead. They go to higher planets.
通常情况下, 在战场上死去的人, 他不会回归守身, 他们会去到高等的星球。
Yeah, the people who killed on the battlefield, they go to higher planets and they reside in the higher planets and they're given a chariot there in the higher planets.
通常情况下就是说这死去他们会去到高等的星球然后在那里还有一个战车。
Sometimes you can see the stars in the sky. Some of the stars in the sky are some of these great people who died in the battle. That they're given a chariot and they become like a star in the sky and they drive their chariots in the sky in the higher planets.
我们在天空中有时候看到一些星星，这些星星有可能就是那些在战场上死去的这些英雄，他们在天空中巡视着。
Yeah, okay.
Okay, the last sentence is that if the demons become the ghost, where will they go?
Well, they're there, they're still there on the battlefield fighting. It said there, that's what it says, right? Saying the ghosts that they became ghosts, and although their heads have been removed from their bodies, they got new bodies. There's Sukracharya, the guru of the demons. He's very powerful, he can bring dead people back to life. Maharaj Bali got killed, he had been killed in the battle, but Sukracharya brought him back to life.
Maharaj Bali, 就是说他在战场上被杀死了，然后 Sukracharya 让他恢复了生命。
So all the demons, some demons are still fighting there. Even though they've got ghost bodies, they're still fighting. Okay, Hare Krishna.
Okay, Hare Krishna.
Okay.
Sati Mataji. Okay.
Hare Krishna, 我们又提上了一个问题，徐小渊，看到吗？最后一个问题。
不对，是今天回答还是下一次？
这个是最后一个问题。
是的，最后一个问题。
如果平时工作中经常出现自言自语的状况和无意识的机械行为，比如随手将重要的东西扔进垃圾桶，这些状况还没有察觉，是不是很危险？是处于愚昧状况之中吗？In the ordinary life, somebody, cannot have some proper consciousness and he do something mechanical and say some words without unconsciousness. Or, for example, he throw out some important things to the dustbin. So these things is unconscious or in the mode of the ignorance.
It's a mode of ignorance.
这个是属于愚昧的状况。
But it may also be that it may.Of course, it's all relative. What we consider, you may consider something important, he didn't consider it important. That's why he threw it out. So everybody has their own opinion about these things.
So everybody has their own opinion about these things.
What's important, what's not important. You can argue about that all your life.
到底什么是重要的，什么是不重要的，你可以在你这一生中一直不停地争辩。
好，今天到这儿，我们感谢萨提玛特基主持，感谢苏布迪拉给我们正太的翻译，感谢所有的奉献者聆听T20，祝福你们生活快乐，Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai。